Kia ora, parents and caregivers of Rolleston College learners. My name's Hayden Shaw and I'm a senior leader at Rolleston College. I've put this video together just to help inform you about some of the learning that's happening while we're in this online world, just to give you more of an insight as to how things happen and to potentially support your child out if they have questions about what's going on. Firstly, I'm going to go through how learning is, I guess, delivered. And that takes place in what you're looking at now, which is Google Classroom. I'll go into that in a little bit more detail. But first of all, every class presents a learning plan at the start of the week. And this learning plan could look like one of the following examples. This one here, for example, which has objectives for the week, what time they have class meets, things that they have to do and who they can get in touch with. Another plan looks like this, where we have the expectations of learning tasks for the week, where the teacher contact details, links that are being made for conversations to be had and meets, etc. So these teachers will make their own plans, but effectively at the start of every week, teachers will put out a plan of learning for the week for the learner who's to go in and see what's expected of them in each class, when the teachers are available and when the class is having meetings. Now, that's obviously right at the start of the week. In terms of Google Classroom, I'm just going to go into a bit more detail as to how that works. In Google Classroom, first of all, we have the stream, which works pretty much like a Facebook newsfeed. If I scroll up and down this one from my Year 11 PE class, you can see that I've made posts in here. I've shared when we're having Google Meets. I've put my week ahead plan in there, and I've got learners commenting or putting things up there as well. So that's in a nutshell what the stream is, but effectively that's where announcements are made. So when a teacher says anything on Classroom, it comes up on there. For more detail, we go to the Classwork tab, and that's where tasks and other material is categorized under these different topics, and which makes it a bit easier to find depending on what's going on in the classroom. So you can see here there's different topics depending on what's going on in that particular class, and you obviously have dates and other things to help you navigate your way through that. So that's how Classroom works, and that's the main tool that learning gets delivered on at Rolleston College. And teachers will use things like I'm using now, which is a Screencastify to deliver instructions, but they'll also write down those instructions as well. So the learners can often see them on a video or read them as well. The last thing, and I guess the big thing, and it fits with the first point I talked about with the plan at the start of the week, the biggest help or support you could give your child is helping them at the start of the week get their schedule sorted. So that might mean using Google Calendar, for instance. I've got my Google Calendar here. If they were to put down when their meets are, when teachers are available, when things are due, when work needs to be done, etc., that might really help them just schedule out their week and also put in their breaks when they're going to do some exercise or catching up with mates online or whatever it is that they're doing. But that's a really useful tool to schedule their week, and any support you could give them at the start of the week to arrange that, I think they would be really grateful, and it would really support them over the week. I hope those tips around Classroom have helped or have given you a better insight. If you've got any questions, please don't hesitate to ask your child's teacher, and we'll go from there. But once again, thank you so much for all the support that you're giving your children through this incredibly unusual and challenging environment that we're currently all operating in. Thank you.